the way I spoke. I went to school in South London, and I was always known as Posh Boy. Quickfire. Memorable audition. I remember going to several, I can't remember what it was now. I think it was a Polanski thing or something. But I went to several auditions where I'd walk in and I was so anti, like I hated theatre school for kids and stuff, because I'd go up with the same kids I'd see at every audition, and they'd just go in, ding, you know, perfect, polished, shiny, and just deliver their lines exactly the same. And I kind of would despise it and find it really cringy and horrible. And I'd go in and just do my own thing, and a lot of the times get the jobs. it was at Pineapple Studios, and there was it was just full of too many people that just looked too gross, and I couldn't handle it. And I told my mum, I can't. This is horrible. I can't do it. I'm sorry. We have to go. So we just left. Oh yeah, I met Ronnie Wood once at just some party. I was like, oh God, that's Ronnie Wood. He said hello to me. He said, oh yeah, no, I really like your work. I mean, but I don't know what to say, but obviously I like you. Everyone does. I said, I really like your jacket, because he had this most amazing, beautiful blue velvet jacket on. And he was like, oh, thanks very much, mate. Yeah. BB King gave it to me. I was like, oh, God. Of course he did. Amazing. Very cool. you know what? I think I could answer that. I think it's true. I did this quite funny, strange, like B movie thing called Baytown Disco. Oh no, it was called Baytown Outlaws in the end, and it had Billy Bob Thornton and Eva Longoria in it. If it's on some strange, bizarre channel or something, and someone's watching, just go, oh, you have to watch this. It's just quite hilarious. It's all about rednecks running around trying to look after me, and I'm fully disabled, and it's just offensive but hilarious and bizarre, and I just like watching other people watch it. I don't know. Most of the time they seem to get it quite spot on. Oh, that I might be stuck up or like, that was more from school though. The way I spoke, I went to school in South London, and I was always known as Posh Boy. And because I was an actor and I'd go off and start filming and get loads of time off school, I think people just assumed I was a bit stuck up. So I'd go, yeah, let's say that. I've done that. That I haven't tried. I'd like to go back into space a bit, really. Everyone's going into space these days. It's very popular. Of Elon and Amazon. So yeah, space, sci-fi, or maybe thriller, or maybe both. Space, sci-fi, thriller. I've got a Nanny McPhee clapperboard. It's normally like small little things, like strange little charms or bits of jewelry or like a little knife or something. I've got a proper like actor's chair, and then I get the different backs from the shoots, and I swap them out depending on which one I want to sit on. Only I can sit on it. Thank you very much for watching. I've been Thomas Brodie-Sangster, but I urge you to go check out The Queen's Gambit. It's out on Netflix at the moment. Enjoy.